Ayan, our next awardee is no other than Honorable Thomas Raymond U. Lising of Barangay San Antonio, Pasig. CAP is the icon of success in public service, leadership, and humanitarian service. May we show you a video clip of CAP Thomas, Honorable Thomas.
Ito ang kauna-unahang programa nyo ngayong year. Tama po ba?
Yes, opo. For the year 2022, ito yung una nating pagdaraos ng ating buwanan na basura to ayuda. Ayo.
Magandang araw po mga kabarangay.
Magandang araw po mga kabarangay.
Araw po mga kabarangay.
Welcome to our weekly Kapitan's Report.
Alright, as I mentioned earlier mga netizens, we have here tonight Honorable Thomas Raymond U. Lising. Of Barangay San Antonio, Pasig. He is the icon of success in public service, leadership, and humanitarian service. Ayan, Cap! Magandang gabi po.
Hi, good evening. Magandang gabi po sa ating mga viewers ng inyong show.
Kamusta po tayo dyan, Cap? Nasa Pasig po tayo ngayon, tama po ba?
Yeah. Nandito. Thankfully, no, in the past weeks, the COVID situation has been a little more mellow than what we have experienced in the past. So kahit papaano, no, tayo sa local government or sa local governance, no, is experiencing a little bit of normalcy already. No, nakakaramdam na tayo ng konting paggaan ng management ng ating komunidad.
Ayan, that's good to know po. Cap, bago tayo lumundag sa mga yan, kung okay lang po ba, we would like to hear a little bit about yourself po. Ayan, konting introduction. Hmm. I know we had a little talk earlier and you mentioned po, no, na matagal na po pala kayo into public service. So, sa mga netizens po natin na nasisilayan kayo ngayong gabi, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, so I am, again, no, I am Thomas Raymond Lising. No? You may call me Raymond pala. Ano, and I am currently the barangay captain of Barangay San Antonio, Pasig City, one of the more premier barangays of our city. And I have been in public service since 2007. So I entered the world of public service as a barangay kagawad, and I was elected for 3 consecutive terms, and that was around 11 years, no, yung tatlong term na yon. And in 2018, I ran for the first time as Punong barangay of Barangay San Antonio, and luckily, no, I am already into my 4th year as our Punong barangay.
Ayan. Cap. Ayan, thank you for letting us. Raymond po pala, no? Thomas ako ng Thomas, dapat pala Cap Raymond. Ayan. Does it run in the family? Yun pong public service, kasi you said you had 3 terms na, no? And then this is your first time to run as barangay captain. So, ano po ba yan? Nasa dugo, kumbaga, ang pagsiservisyo sa bayan?
Wala po. Actually, I am the only one in the family. So, it seems like parang wala rin may gusto naman magmana, no? So, mukhang matatapos naman na ako lang ako lang ang na mapapasok sa ganitong larangan. But then it was hindi ko pagpapalit. I mean yung if not or almost what 14 years, 15 years of my life has been dedicated to public service, and it's something that I won't exchange for any other experience pa, kumbaga.
Kaya bago ba ikaw pumasok sa politika, are you into a different area? O since you were young, ito na talaga yung pinasok mo?
Wala rin sa plano natin, ano. Our family is a family of business men and business women, or entrepreneurs, if you may call them. So it wasn't really a yung nakaplano, hindi, wala siya sa plano. Pero sinasabi naman ng iba, no, malamang nakaguhit na sa palad mo yan. Kaya siguro ay pinag-adya rin, no, na tayo ay mapunta rin sa ganitong career.
Parang cliche nga, no, Kap? Pero I believe kasi meron yung mga trigger points eh kung bakit bigla kang pumasok sa ganyan, tapos nagustuhan mo na. And hindi ako from politics, but I think that is really a hard industry to be in, ano? So ano, meron po ba something that triggered your heart to basically do this? As you said nga po, galing kayo sa business, ano? So yeah. Ayun. Is there
siguro I've always been a people person naman. It's not naman na, I've always been luckily surrounded by friends, a lot of people. I like really meeting new people. So perhaps it was a natural transition for me. With regard naman to handling the job that requires, no, of this career or of this profession. Siguro yung roots ko rin in business management, no, malaki rin ang siguro na itulong noon sa atin, sa diskarte, and of course a resourcefulness, kasi being in public service also requires a lot of someone to be resourceful, ano. We understand that there is funding. Pero somehow to innovate, you really have to collaborate and be open to new ideas, no? Primarily kami, no, we, one of our adjustments para maging inclusive ang community and to empower our community is really to professionalize our social media platforms, adapt some digital advances, di ba, in terms of technology. So siguro malaking bagay 'yon na yung how open we are in terms of these aspects para mag-succeed rin, no, dito sa serbisyo publiko.
Very true nga, Kap. 'Di ba? Kailangan yung nakikita ng resident nung yung mga
constituents
mo yung ginagawa. I think that is very important and very essential. And as you said, you've used social media. Tama po ba? Yes. Tell us a little bit more. Do you do it regularly? I saw from your video you have your weekly report.
Yeah, so actually, no, yung sabi naman natin, ano, yung teknolohiya nandiyan na yan, diba? So again, like any other thing, no, there is a good and a bad to it, no. But then again, what's important is perhaps using it wisely, no, na kung saan na yung makakatulong, no, sa paglilingkuran. So in our case, no, it was one of our priorities po talaga na to professionalize, ano, when I was elected in 2018, it was the height of Facebook already and other social media platforms, and we did have an existing Facebook account then, but then what we wanted was something interactive, eh, na kung saan talaga ang ating netizens, no, in particular ay talagang makakapag magiging feedback mechanism siya para sa amin. And of course, it would be our avenue also in order to showcase naman what we have done in the past, no? So ang aming common, no, na naririnig ko kasi hindi nararamdaman ng barangay or hindi nararamdaman ng gobyerno. So we capitalized on the reach of social media, and thankfully, no, since it was one of the first things that we did, no, when I assumed the post in 2018, so medyo nagamay na namin. And of course, the gain na ng followers, ng likes, yung aming Facebook platform. And then talagang nagamit namin siya ng maigi nung pandemic. It was the only way and the best way siguro for our constituents to reach us. Syempre, no, it's easier to filter things pagka sa Facebook, eh, rather than ina-out mo yung cellphone number mo. Of course, we have our hotlines na kung saan pwedeng tumawag ang ating mga constituents. Pero one thing that we realized, no, quite a few na lang ang tumatawag sa landlines. No?
Yeah.
So, when they have inquiries or even so feedback, no, talagang dinadaan nila sa social media. And siguro, mas naging efficient ang aming paghahatid ng serbisyo and pag-aksyon, no? Sabi ko nga before, no, nung walang pandemya, no, paano kaya yung mga public servants noon, no? Syempre hindi mo naman mababantayan ang bawat sulok ng iyong kinasasakupan. And thankfully, no, because of this, no, kaagad na nabibring to our attention. Imagine kung hindi natin mabibigyan ng attention yon or aksyon, mamumuuna lang yun na galit, no? Galit sa gobyerno. Na kung tutuusin naman ay simpleng-simpleng bagay lamang na pwede naman bigyan ng solusyon.
Pero clearly it states the ano, the importance of communication, ano po ba, in all aspect.
And yun nga, Miss Jenny, of kami, very particular kami with inclusivity. We really want our community to be as a whole in terms of the services, ha. So, of course, in my 14, 15 years in public service, di ba, hindi maaalis. Minsan may selosan din sa mga constituents. Mm-hmm. O, ba't yun lang ang napapansin nyo?
Yeah.
O, ba't doon lang kayo lagi, di ba? So, sa siguro, no, yung mga gantong pamamaraan, no, na naka-reach tayo sa kanila, no, na naabot natin ang ating mga constituents, na, which we believe, no, majority of which are online. Diba? Or are connected, diba? So kahit senior citizens, nakakatuwa, they're very engaged kahit sa mga social media platforms natin.
That's good. Cap, was there a time, kumbaga meron ba kayo, siguro I would say ano na lang, kasi I assume marami, the memorable incident na sa tingin nyo, halimbawa while you're doing your weekly, no, may nanonood and then reacted into what you're saying, na kinailangan ng tulong, that because of social media you were able to immediately put action into what is needed.
That is true, no. Actually, it has become a norm already for us, no, yung quick reaction reaction, no, in terms of kung meron magse-send ng private message, magko-comment, no. Of course, we do have our ways naman para i-verify. No? Hindi naman maaalis, may netizens talaga tayo na hindi naman natin alam kung totoo rin ang sinasabi. So, tayo naman, no? we have our ways of verifying, validating. And in the soonest possible time, tayo naman binibigyan natin kaagad ng action kung ano man ang hinaing, no? Just as long as the concern is valid, di ba? Tayo, mabilis naman natin na actionan yun.
Yeah, that's good, Cap. Cap, any memorable or I know you're still working on a lot of projects, pero yeah, meron ba yung you want to also to promote and at the same time something, a project that is really close to your heart as of this time?
Well, siguro it was included also in our video, no? We're very proud of our Basura to Ayuda program, no, that we started back in October of 2020. So it was our way of again providing ayuda. Alam naman natin yung term na ayuda ay usong-uso in the last 2 years. And syempre, we wanted something that would, a program that would empower our residents, our constituents from all ages, no, na makatulong natin sa pag-aalaga sa kalikasan. So this is our program, no, na kung saan ay ang ating mga constituents ay nagto-turn over ng kanilang mga recyclable wastes or plastic waste na nasesegregate nila sa kanilang mga tahanan. And in exchange for a certain weight of plastic waste, they get a kilo of rice. So, naging successful naman yung ating launch. And again, it was a collaboration with one of our residents na talagang advocate din ng kalikasan. So, ang nakakatuwa dito is the barangay or ang gobyerno, ang pamahalaan ay nakaka-create ng programs through citizens empowerment and collaboration, di ba, with other institutions related to the advocacy of our program. So because of this, we have we've had a lot ng mga environmental allies, as we call it, no, ng mga kakampi, ika nga sa pag aalaga sa kalikasan. And We've recently celebrated our first year anniversary for Basura to Ayuda, and we're very happy, no, that it has become one of our more sustainable programs, no, in Barangay San Antonio. Again, this Saturday we will be having our Basura to Ayuda for the month of March. So we always do it every last Saturday of the month, and nakakatuwa that our constituents really look forward to this activity.
Yeah. Nung narinig ko Basura to Ayuda, paano yun? Naintriga ako while I was watching your video. Then now I know. So they collect all the plastics, which is good. Minsan, di ba, kasi?
Yeah. Kasi isang problema natin, di ba, ma'am, no? We are encouraged to segregate in our homes, di ba, para sa kalikasan. But the problem is, where do we bring these segregated
items?
So that's where it becomes a dead end for most of the citizens. So siguro kami po sa barangay, no, we are very happy na kahit papaano we have created this avenue para po sa ating mga constituents. In fact, when we started this, mas mataas pa yung kilo ng bigas, mas malaki, no? Pero sabi nga namin, baka maging driven na lang siya by the ayuda and not by that habit,
the purpose of ano,
yes,
yung thought na you have to take care of the
environment. So siguro after 2 to 3 months, sandwich lang namin, sabi natin babaan natin yung ano, yung kilo ng bigas, just to see, no, if the public would still support and engage. And thankfully, no, kami nagpapasalamat sa ating mga kabarangay na patuloy pa rin, no, ang kanila support. Ika nga, hindi naging hadlang yung pagbaba ng kilo ng bigas or yung amount ng ayuda para sila makiisa, no, dito sa ating programa.
Yeah, actually I think very good yung idea na yun, eh, kasi like hindi po ako taga Manila ko, pero sometimes kasi you want to teach the kids na okay, that's etong plastic, it can be, kasi in other countries they can convert it into, 'di ba, may certain amount. Meron nga yung dispenser, they put there the plastics and then they get money out of it. Pero right, dito sa atin, right, syempre wala yung ganun. And hindi normal. I mean, hindi every city or every place would have that information, right, na uy, kokolektahin namin 'yan. Plus meron ka pang ano, incentive.
Yeah. So siguro yun yung isa sa naging driving force din namin, no, para ipatupad ito, no, sa aming komunidad. And we're very lucky, no, that the yung acceptance ng publiko ay napakaganda. And minsan nga yung iba hindi pa second to the last Saturday pa lang nagme-message sa amin, eh, kasi parang iniisip nila yun na yun, no. Pero so kami yung gana, no, and of course yung engagement, eh, that's very important, eh, kasi if empowered ang citizens mo, they get to participate in your programs. I guess it shows the kind of leadership that a community has. And again, it's one of those things that our constituents could be proud of. Diba na, oh, meron kami nito. Diba? Yeah. And talaga nakikiisa kami dyan.
Yeah, it's very good kasi hindi naman siya super effort. I mean, it's something that you have every day kasi bumibili ka eh.
Yeah, and yeah, then, may consumption eh. May consumption.
Oh. So it's a simple way, parang one thing you are helping, second thing na didispose mo in the right way. Plus, as, do they make it as something? Like, there are companies who build chairs and all that.
Yeah, yun yung nabanggit ko nga na we do have, or nakakolekta rin kami ng mga environmental allies no, in the past years. Kasi we do have partner companies or NGOs already, or from the start, no, sila naman ang partners din namin, nadadagdagan lang, that really repurpose these recyclable plastics or waste. And ang problem rin nila is really raw materials. Eh. So, naghahanap din talaga sila ng communities that na mayroong mga gantong activity na kung saan nagkakaroon sila ng mga pagkukolekta ng mga plastic waste or recyclable waste kasi yun ay raw materials nila para sa kanilang mga produktong ginagawa. Tama kayo, yung chairs, plant boxes, flower pots, coasters, may mga ganyan eh. So, kami naman po, we don't ask anything in return from our partners. Ang sabi lang namin, masaya na kami na meron kaming nababagsakan, kumbaga, or nakakatiran nitong mga items na ito. And kung sila man ay may mga partner na, let's say, less fortunate communities, because some of them really do, sabi namin, i-donate nyo na lang doon. Diba? At least mas marami tayong natutulungan at ang Barangay San Antonio ay naging bahagi no, nung ganyong effort or may ambag kami sa effort na yun.
Nakakatuwa how you see how each one has part to make something, yes. Ano.
Totoo naman, of course, merong catalyst yan, may mag-uumpisa yan, but kailangan pa rin ng yung magsama-sama eh. Diba? It may sound cliche, diba? Pero talagang kailangan magsama-sama para talagang magkaroon din ng kaayusan.
Very true. Congratulations on that, Cap. Pero aside from that, I know that I can see it's really a good thing. But what other projects are in line, ayan, that you can maybe promote to everyone who's watching at the moment?
Yeah, so promote ko na rin no, this coming Saturday, it's March 26. Bukod sa Basura to Ayuda, may kasabay kaming event pala gagawin since it's Rabies Awareness Month. So we will be having a free anti-rabies rabies vaccination and it's going to be drive-through. So drive-through na anti-rabies vaccination and then I suppose it's the first of its kind again in our city. I'd say we are the first barangay again who has who will be implementing this vaccination no, para sa mga aso at pusa. Drive-through. Now, we always do it ng, it's our first time to do it, no? So before, the conventional type, pupunta sila sa barangay hall, may pila, so and so. Pero sabi nga namin, di ba, of course, with the COVID situation, hindi pa naman din tapos ang laban natin sa COVID. So, siguro, as much as possible, once the barangay initiates programs, no, let's still make it a point that health and safety protocols are still observed. Mahirap pa sisi.
Very true naman yan, Cap. So yeah, I'm amazed and I'm very happy with all those projects that you have. Ipagpatuloy po natin yan. And once again, congratulations po sa inyo. So we can sense na talagang your constituents really appreciate and know and can see what you are doing for them. Ayan, because you are the awardee for the icon of success in public service leadership and humanitarian services. Cap,
malaking karangalan to. Yeah, malaking karangalan po sa amin. And I always say, no, yung ginagawa naman namin is first and foremost, no, we want our constituents to be proud no, of our community and the leadership that we have in our barangay.
And congratulations, Cap. Once again, yes. Well done on your achievement. Yeah. And thank you so much po, syempre, for gracing the show and being here with us, mentioning all your projects. Yan. So now we know, so kung wala pong ganun katulad ng meron kinakap, baka pwede natin katukin yung mga barangay natin. That's a good initiative, actually.
Yeah, kami naman, we really hope no, na whatever best practices that we have, no, I hope we get to influence also or create an impact for other communities as well. No, kami naman, at some point, nanggagaya din naman kami. Diba, we get ideas also from other communities and tweak it a little bit na magiging adaptable naman siya sa aming komunidad. So I guess yung sharing of best practices is really important, lalo na sa amin na nasa lingkod bayan.
Yeah, very true. I agree with you, Cap. Ayan, imagine kung bawat bawat barangay or bawat community would have something different, something I find it amazing kasi hindi naman lahat merong ganun. So our place would be a better place.
Correct, cliche
man, pero it's something. It start from somewhere. Start from small thing before you go big.
Correct. Tsaka sabi nga namin, it doesn't matter if ikaw naman ang nauna. Diba? What's important is you create a huge impact no, sa iyong komunidad, di ba? And of course, you get to inspire also other people para kumbaga maging trickle effect siya in terms of yung paghahatid ng mga programs and services sa ating komunidad.
Yeah, and it's somehow like parang it's an affirmation that you're doing doing a good job.
Yeah, or nagtatrabaho, di ba?
Yeah,
yun naman
yeah,
ang ating ano dyan eh. Sabi nga namin, itong public service, sometimes they think it's a really glamorous job, no? Pero ano lang yan, surface lang yan, diba? Mas marami yung hirap rather than yung sarap. And of course, pag kami naman humarap sa publiko, hindi rin naman pwede na parang mukha kaming nahihirapan, no? Kasi tayo rin ang tutularan, eh. So, if meron kang disposition na hindi maganda, diba? Magte-trickle down din yan sa iyong community members.
Yeah, living by example, ika nga.
Correct, tama.
Ayan. Alright, thank you so much, Cap. Nag-enjoy po kami sa kamustahan natin and sharing all your projects with all of us. Once again, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Netizens, once again, Honorable Thomas Raymond U. Lising of Barangay San Antonio, Pasig. He is the icon of success in public service, leadership, and humanitarian service. See
you, Cap. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
See you next week. Thank you. Good evening.